Now I know all y'all done heard of me. I'm still the M-O-E. I'm on my second CD and I'm nationwide. I'm still pulling up eyes, representing the south side. Third-born veteran, still squashing cash.
What's up, everybody? Gain of no Lexus. It's your boy Black Sean Groove, man. Some Street Culture Entertainment. Before I start this video, man, I need y'all to like and subscribe, man. I also need y'all to hit the notification button, man, and I need y'all also to give me some comments about what y'all think about these situations I be bringing up, man. But over the last few days, I've been noticing a lot of reports, a lot of sexual abuse reports, and a lot of sexual abuse reports and accusations from siblings, from minors that were siblings of Tiffany Haddish and Aries Spears. Tiffany Haddish is a comedian from South Central LA that I love, that I salute, that I respect and kind of half-ass look up to because she came up in the foster system in South Central LA and she overcame a whole bunch of bullshit and still became somebody. And it kind of reminds me of my life, even though it wasn't as worse as my life, but it still reminds me of my life and lets me know I can still be somebody. And Aries Spears is another comedian who I discovered when he was 18 years old on Def Comedy Jam. But as time went on, he was on Mad TV and on different movies. He's a pretty funny dude. But lately, he's been getting a lot of backlash because a week or two ago, he did an interview on DJ Vlad. And he basically body shamed and talked bad about Lizzo. And I made a video about that, but I didn't find out till after I made the video that during the same interview, at the same time he was talking about Lizzo, he dissed himself too. He also talked about how bad he looks and how fat he is and his blood pressure. And it doesn't make it right, but at least he talked about himself while he was talking about her. So I can kind of cut him a little slack. But they were accused of molesting two siblings that were minors. I'm going to read the report for y'all so y'all can get a glimpse of what I'm talking about. A woman and her younger brother have accused comedians Tiffany Haddish and Aries Spears in a new lawsuit of grooming them when they were children and coercing them into filming sexually explicit skits. The lawsuit was filed in Los Angeles Superior Court on Tuesday by siblings identified only as Jane Doe, now 22, and John Doe, who was born in 2007. Who is John's legal guardian, is the plaintiff in the lawsuit, both individually and on her younger brother's behalf. The lawsuit alleges that Haddish and Spears coerced the siblings when they were children to take part in sexually explicit skits in separate incidents, which they say stole the youth of a 7-year-old and a 14-year-old. The lawsuit was first reported by Daily Beast. Attorneys for Haddish and Spears have dismissed the lawsuit as a shakedown. In a separate statement, Andrew Brettler, an attorney for Haddish, said the plaintiff's mother had been trying to assert these bogus claims against Haddish for several years. Calling the allegations meritless, Brettler said Haddish has previously shown she would not be shaken down. Now, the accuser's mother has her adult daughter represent her in this lawsuit. The two of them would together face the consequences of pursuing this frivolous action, the attorney said. Jane said she and her brother are not surprised that Mr. Brettler would attempt to divert the attention from the legitimate claims filed by the brother and me to shift the blame and attention to our mother, who is not a party of this lawsuit. In 2013, Haddish appeared as a guest speaker at a summer camp Jane, then 14, attended, the lawsuit said. During the visit, Haddish allegedly told Jane that she had the perfect role for her. Neither Jane nor her mother were aware of what the shoot would entail, the lawsuit alleged, adding only Spears and Haddish knew the storyline for the skit. Now, how I feel about this situation. Now, this can be a possible shakedown because they say this lady's been cool with Tiffany Haddish for several years and met her on the comedy circuit. And it is very possible she is trying to shake her down because she might have been trying to get something from her that she wants and she won't give it to her. Or, you know, it can be any reason she's trying to shake her down. She can just be going through hard times and like, fuck it, let me take her down. Also, on the other end, though, I know a lot of stars feel like they're invincible and above the law, and a lot of them feel like they can do what the fuck they want to do with no consequences. And I'm not saying this is the situation, but it's possible. Now, we'll never know until they have their day in court and everything comes out. We'll never know who is telling the truth. But it's an unfortunate situation because, like I say, Tiffany Haddish, you're looked up to by a lot of young black women. They look at you as inspiration. You come from where a big percentage of black women come from. Broken homes, the ghetto, foster system, different shit. So I would advise you just be careful at whatever you do because they're itching. Motherfuckers are itching to knock you off your square. You're a successful black woman from the hood and you still keep it hood, which makes them hate you more. So any chance they gonna get, they gonna knock you off your pedestal. So watch yourself, sister. Ari Spears. A lot of people already hate you from the comments you made about Lizzo. Not just that, just from comments you made over the past. Then on top of that, a lot of people know you from the Corey Holcomb show, the 5150 show in 2017 when Zoe Williams beat you up on the show. One man beat you up and balled you up on the show. Not five like they was on Zero. One man balled you up. So my advice to you is, you walking on thin ice, Aries. You're a funny dude. You're a funny comedian. You know what I'm saying? You real talented, bro. But you got to watch what you do and what you say because, like you said yourself, y'all are in the public eye. So anything you say is going to be misconstrued and used and twisted around like how the media does, bro. Nowhere when they reported what you said about Lizzo, nowhere did they say that you were talking about yourself at the same time. I realized that when I went back and looked at the interview that you were talking about yourself at the same time you're talking about Lizzo. So you got to watch what you say, man. I just want to tell y'all people out there, man, they got money and feel like you're above the law, man. You're not above the law, man. One day some of the shit you do going to come crashing down and that money ain't going to be able to save you. And I'm not saying that Tiffany Haddish and Ari Spears are guilty, like I said before. But I'm saying this is the mind state of a lot of people who got money. So y'all be aware that whatever you do will come to the light one day, even when it's your old man. My name is Black Sean Groove from Street Culture Entertainment, Street Culture TV, man. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. Don't forget to hit the notification button so you can get a notification when I drop videos. And also, leave a comment. If you want to cash app and help my channel, I don't usually do this shit, but if you want to cash app and help my channel, man, you can cash app me at $CuzLife, $CUHZLYFE. I'ma holler at y'all, man.